afternoon, twin flames, soul flames, lovers, how are you all doing? Woohoo! What an exciting week this was. It was a week of the merry-go-round, you know? It was a thrilling week. Yes, that's the right word, a thrilling week, with a lot of things going on, with clearing out some old energies. For the feminine was a week of transformation, a week of her insecurities, not feeling comfortable, feeling looked at, and it could be that it was a kind of feeling that she's being gazed at, and she is being censored. That's what I hear. She was censored. They're checking her out, checking her energy out, who she is, what she is, what kind of person she is. And that was really interesting, because they seen behind the mask, they seen behind maybe the defense she is putting up. It could be she's been looked at by many men, and I think she has a kind of armor on her, so she won't be, so the people won't see who she really is. And they found out who she really was and who she really is, and that they saw through everything. And that's really amazing. It's really amazing that that there are people that going beyond what the outer world is, what you want to show to the outer world. You know, sometimes there are times that you want to armor yourself against energies or against people, and you're withdrawing yourself, or you be quiet for a while, and you're turning inside, and then people see anyway who you are. So that's a kind of comforting in that space, but it can also, for other people, can be very uncomfortable. Well, it's depending how you seeing it. So yeah, the divine masculine. Wow. I'm so proud of the divine masculine. I'm so proud of him, because he is going next level. He's going next level. You see, he is going next level in his environment. You see, he's going next level in the way he thinks, the way he acts. He is more coming in maturity, and I'm really proud of the masculines, because even if they get in difficult situations, the love in his heart, and the open heart connection, is winning it. So that's really beautiful. That's really beautiful. So, oh, this is already popping out the mirror. Who or what is triggering you that is also in another person and within you? And those triggers you need to resolve, and that's really beautiful, because in the feminine's heart space, that is already happened. So there is a huge transformation in the feminine, I see. Okay, let's go. What's going on in the divine masculine's mind space? Take the next step. Oh my God. Stupid thing. Yeah, I get a lot of messages in today. Yeah, it's getting me out of my concentration. Stepping stones. Take the next step. Let go of the old paradigm and go beyond. You know that you're going through that higher to that higher frequency. You're taking the stepping stones and you're putting your toes in the water, you know, feeling, is it possible for me to make is it possible for me to make the next step, or is it possible that I or that I stay at shore? That's what I feel. But I see him, you know, putting his toe in the water, and saying, "Okay, I'm seeing like a little child that is a little scared for the water, for the cold water, but want to step to go in anyway." So a little bit of that shivering energy. He says I feel I need to go to a higher place, that that I can see and do more, but also staying in that heart space, staying in that space of, you know, I'm taking a next step. Yeah, I'm going to challenge myself. Yes, give myself another challenge. And that could be by, you know, for some men, stretching. I'm already purging here for the masculine. I'm feeling my body getting stronger. I'm feeling that's interesting that they let me feel this, that I'm getting stronger in my physical appearance, that I'm getting stronger in my heart, that I better can connect with my heart space and explain and show people how I feel, and show people how he is connecting with them on a deeper emotional level. So he is taking new steps also I hear his mind is very strong and connecting with the dragons. It's really amazing. He's connecting, if you see it here on the card on this side, there's a dragon. Let me see. Yeah, there's a dragon. And he's connecting with the dragon energy, you know, and let the dragon transform, and let the dragon take him away to another realm, you know, and raising his vibration and letting go of the old paradigm stuff that people are connected to. He's not dealing with that anymore. So that's really amazing for the divine masculine. She sees the he and she. When you're feminine, it's your masculine side. When you're a masculine, you know, it's your masculine side. Of course it is. They say masculine is a masculine, and the feminine has a masculine side in her. So she is. Is showing more compassion and love and light and raising above everything else. The masculine is really coming, really blossoming. And he got what he deserved, I hear. He gets what he deserves this week. You know, he gets the love, he gets the compassion, he gets the... how do you call it? Admiration? Admiration? I don't know the... Yeah. Admiration. Admiration, I hear. He gets the admiration that he is waiting for such a long time. You know? Yeah, because he takes... He's taking... He's not staying stuck. Hanging around with the same people. You know, he's moving upwards. He's moving to another, yeah. Oh, like oh, there's more than just that. What I'm doing, there's more, you know. And when I'm putting my love and my energy into it, then everything is opening up. He's surprised about that. That's really good. So that's the next step and the next level what he's going to take. You know, it's really fun what I see. It's really beautiful what I see. In his heart space, ships of light. Beam up your vibration. Open up to your star family. And that's what the Divine Masculine is doing at the moment. You know, it could be that he is seeing falling stars, or that he is seeing, you know, UFOs or ships of light, or he sees and discovers that the planets are brighter. He is looking upwards, and he is really searching for the clarity on the sky, I hear, for the higher vibration and the higher light on the sky. And it's really amazing in this piece, because he is more open to it, to the star family. He's more open to his star family. He's more open to receive the light codes and the codes that are transmitted to him. You know, so he gets his upgrades in his heart space. And you see him shine. You see him start shining this week. You know, his heart is opening. And because of the light codes and the higher frequency that's comes in. Of the star family, of the Galactic Federation, of the planets, the Arcturians, the Palladians, the Andromedans, Sirius, you know, Lyran. Lyran is very active at the moment. We have the light, the Lion's Gate and the White Lions at the moment that are really charging in. So that's really beautiful. So how does he see the Divine Feminine? The Syrian and missionaries. The dream for the new earth. Time now for a miracle, a magical life. So he sees that she is connecting with a magical life. She's connecting with the higher frequencies. That she is dreaming about this new earth. Dreaming about the new humanity. Without manipulation, without the control, without anything, with no boundaries. You know, in some cases you need to have boundaries when there are people with a lower frequency, because they are controlling, and then you have to give your boundaries. And when you raise above that, you know, and give your boundaries, and then let it go, then you're coming into that higher frequency of this magical life. And he sees that he can have a magical life with the Divine Feminine. You know, that they are on that same frequency. That it's not about thinking that they are on the on a different frequency. If you think that you're on a different frequency, you are. And at the moment that you are on a higher frequency, in the highest frequency, we all know that, right? What the highest frequency is. So yeah, just go there, and you have an amazing life. You have the, you're entering the golden age. Divine feminine in a mind space, essences and energies. Attuned to subtle energies, get the balance, and you are a frequency holder. So it means that it could be that you are attuning in to the very soft and fine energies, because your sensors are so sensitive and taking it all in, that that you feel everything. You even feel the emotion behind some person of someone, not about the person itself, but you can tune behind it, behind all the entities, behind all the ancestral lines, behind everything what's going on. So she is tuning in to all these energies to see what these energies are doing in an environment that they don't belong in. Because they're wrecking up the whole fucking place with their energy. And they're not even aware, because they know that's the person they are. So they don't see the energies behind it. What is the energy doing behind it? What is it, its task? What are they? What are their commands? What do they need to do? And that's can be ancestral, but it can also be from another vibration, another energy. And she's checking them all out. You know, she's checking out, okay, is this an entity? This is an entity. What is that entity want in that group of people? Creating disturbances, creating discomfort, creating disharmony, want to interrupt things, want to take the place. And there the fear of that entity, or the nervousness of that entity, they leave it in that fucking place. They leave it in the house. They leave it everywhere they go. So the Divine Feminine is checking in on that. And she's clearing out that space. She's clearing out what she's doing for the Divine Masculine. She's clearing out everything that is not that shouldn't be there. You know, you can be a very beautiful person, but if you have a ache in your body, or you're sick in your body, then you have an entity attachment to it, because the entity is feeding off that illness. And then you get the disharmony, and then you have to see, you know, is this good for instance, if you go to a very serene place, or you're going to someone who's very intuitive, or who's very sensitive, and you see all these energies behind it, wow, then there's a lot of work to do, you know, because the energies want to disrupt the place. And that's what the Divine Feminine sees. So she is clearing out all the energies and bring back everything into balance, because they are a frequency holder, and with that frequency she can remove out, she can move out all the lower frequencies there are, you know. So so she is clearing a lot of things. She's clearing a lot of spaces, but also for the Divine Masculine. You know, if she sees that the divine masculine gets attacked or whatever, you know, she's she is there to clear the energy. Okay. What's in the divine feminine's heart space? Release the entities. Release the lower frequencies. And release your identities. Release the identities that you're holding on to, you know. And that's probably what is holding the divine feminine in a kind of cage in her heart space. Because there are a lot of insecurities there, and there's a lot of fear, there needs to be shed light on that fear. And I hear that fear is from the ancestral realm, that is from the ancestors. She needs to release that lost cloak, you know, if she wants to move further. You know, she needs to release that lost cloak before she can enter the next portal, I hear. You know, before she can enter the next phase in her life. And if she's not doing that work, she will not enter. So, yeah, I start to purge already for the feminine now. It's from the heart space that she needs to leave the old identities behind her. Wow. And if she needs essences for that or other energies to support her, then she needs to do that. She needs to do that. So it could be that there is a imbalance for the divine feminine now because of the lion's gate, the lion portal, that a lot of chaos is coming in. And how quick do you reset yourself? You know, are you going to sob in that emotion and you saying, "Oh, I'm a victim. I'm feeling so sorry for myself." Or do you say, "Okay, turn it around. I put myself into a new vision. That's where I want to go, and I'm going that way." It's up to you, and that's about releasing that lost cloak. You know, you can change everything, and that's the magic. That's the magic. That's the pure magic. What you can do. How does she see the divine masculine? You are loved. You are safe. You need to rest and sleep well. And the divine feminine is guarding your back. It doesn't matter in which dream world you are, in which realm you're warring, she will find you, she will hold you, and she will guard your back. She is this support. She supports him. The divine masculine is supporting so many other people, and sometimes not really thinking about himself, but then he needs a place to come home to and to rest well, you know. And doing this in the Divine Mother cosmic womb, or you know, resting at her side and be in that space that he can upload his energy again, you know. You see the spiral, otherwise the spiral, he's connecting with that spiral of her heart. And if he is not doing this, he's going into this spiral down there. And the joy that she's bringing, and the lightheartedness, that is, and the light codes that she's bringing in, that is giving him, you know, new energy. Okay. Because the life force, for the masculines who are on still in the third dimensional realm, that I see that the masculine in the third dimensional realm, the life force is getting sucked out of him. You know, the life force is getting sucked out of him. And that's really on a very, very low vibration. It's for the other person, it's the food. And for the divine masculine, he is losing his power. He's losing his power by it. So that's why he needs to upgrade his energy to connect. And connect with the cosmic mother womb, you know. The cosmic mother, the... that's funny because I told it before. The masculine has to go to the higher realm, and the divine feminine needs to go more to the earth. And that's what's happening. They're changing roles now, because the masculine was always on the earth, was always that stable, controlling energy. And logical, and now he needs to go up and entering his intuition, you know, feeling safe in the realm, and then balancing it all out. And that's what's happening now. The divine feminine is already more balanced than the divine masculine, because he still has to find his place in that higher realm. A lot of masculines are scared of that place. Okay, what will support the divine masculine? Doorways into the now. Letting go of your warrior. Wow. Letting go of your warrior. You're fighting. You're fighting. You're in connecting with the portals. Holding space for the portals, and it's now there is no divine timing in the fifth dimensional realm. Everything happens in the now. Everything is in this moment what is happening. And when you're in this moment, you don't have to fight, because then you're safe, you're grounded, and You can let go of the fight. Fighting starts when you see something in the future that you don't like. Fighting starts when you're in the past and you're still fighting. Or, you know, seeing the things of the past and not able to accept it. Then you're fighting. Then you're constantly in that warrior in the warrior mode. And some masculines out there really understand what I mean by this, because I had many masculines you know, going through the four elements, so they know what I mean with, you know, go to your lover, you know, and give the warrior some rest. Because you're fighting your own. You're not fighting someone else. You're fighting your own. And, you know, I also feel a lot of jealousy with the masculine. Maybe towards the feminine, or towards that someone has more talent or has more skills, or are easier going, or have more... are younger, or whatever, you know, that jealousy is. Let that go, because that's your warrior. That's just your warrior fighting. So let it go and step through that step through the doorway to the elven realm. Connect with the elf. Connect with the fairies. You know, she is tired and he is tired. To fight all the time and to be aware, you know, be aware of what everything is happening around him. If you're raising your vibration to a higher frequency, it's gone. All those energies are gone because you're in a higher element of light. And that's why the star family is coming in to give you the codes. To give you the codes, to give you the nurturing, to give you the energy. And that's your family. You know that. You don't... some masculines don't talk about it, right? They don't talk about it. They don't want anyone to know that they're going there, you know, in meditation or in their sleep. And meeting the Divine Feminine in that realm. But the Divine Feminine sees it because she's so sensitive. You know? She is working with those subtle energies. So, if for instance, if you have an energy around you that's from a lower frequency, and I see, for instance, you're working in a shop and you're very high sensitive and you're connecting with your family of light, you know, and you don't tell anyone, but the vibration will be so high that everybody around it can sense that. And the Divine Feminine, for instance, the Divine Feminine really sensed it. You know, the sense, you know, there's this going on, there's that going on, there's that going on. So maybe you need to release that warrior energy and move up to a higher frequency. And you can't do anything about it because it's already happening. You know, it's already happening. And, you know, if you're connected to the elven realm and the fairy realm, you know, you're already there. You're already there. Doesn't mean that they are not from a high frequency when they are in the inner earth. They're just as much in a higher high frequency. Because not all the elements are... in the universe, you know, it's also in our earth. You know, if I connect with my dragons or with my unicorns or with my fairies, then it's already there, you know. And then I feel that high frequency of the earth instead of the orcs, right? So. It's really funny how they say that. Yeah. So go there. So go there. Go to that realm and create some magic for yourself. Yeah. How does he see the Divine Feminine? She is raising to the Palladian frequencies. They have a sacred bond. They're having healing clear space for the higher energies. So there is a lot of healing. They're clearing the space for a higher energy. They're clearing their own spaces. And they're clearing their space for a higher energy. You know? And when they're doing this and clearing that out, everything is super, super, super high frequency. And they have that sacred bond together. You know, in that realm, that's, you know, and when it's time, it's now after the Lion's Gate, a lot of twin flames are coming together. So it could be that both are in alignment and they're both in that frequency that you can raise that frequency and where they meet. And when they meet in the astral plane and now through the Lion's Gate, it's time to merge on the earth plane, because they see that they are exactly in the same vibration. They are exactly where the he knows where the feminine is. He knows where the masculine and he knows where the masculine is. So, and that's what he sees. He sees her in that Palladian frequency. Okay, divine feminine. Receive your birthright, receive your light, and step in your divine feminine essence, the unconditional love, the purity of the heart, the Mary Magdalene energy, the Lemurian energy, the softness. So it's time for the feminine to receive the love, to not to give it, because she gave already enough. She just birthed the abundance. She just birthed the whole sun, right? So now it's time that she can relax and receive the love that she really is. Deserving, yeah, it's her birthright, right? The abundance, the joy, the happiness, the prosperity, it's all her birthright. So it's now time to receive that unconditional love from whatever source, right? Could be the divine masculine, but it could also be the higher source. Beautiful. How does she see the divine masculine in union? Peace beyond survival. And oh wow. 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 Yeah, that's why I said, you know, I'm so proud of the divine masculine. He's the peacemaker through inner peace. Resolving, and he resolving ancient splits. So there is still a task for the divine masculine, you know, going beyond his anger and going into love. And there is still an issue that he needs to resolve with or the divine feminine or with his inner child that he is still protecting. So it could be that he needs to make peace with his inner child and or going beyond that. And if he sees this in the divine feminine, you know, it could be that the divine feminine is seeing this in the divine masculine, that it's maybe time for him to make peace with his divine feminine. On which issue it is, you know, because he reacts out of survival and not reacting out of his heart space. You know, he got pushed into a and controlled into a situation, and it could be that he wasn't able to talk to his divine feminine. From a third party or, you know, another realm, that he wasn't able to talk to her the way he wanted to from his heart space. And that that he removed divine feminine, and that the feminine, you know, fell behind it and thought, okay, here we go again. I cut you off. Because you're still playing the same old song. And now she's seeing that he wants to have peace. And he wants to go beyond that survival mode. And resolving the ancient splits. Because that wasn't his intention in his heart space. So, you know, I always say, no matter what people say, don't always listen to them, because your own heart is speaking. And if you start to listen to other people, you will be schizophrenic within 10 seconds, because if they're all going to talk at the same time, you're going nuts and your energies get shattered. So it's really from the importance that you always listen to your own heart. Okay, so let's see what's going on in the with the other cards. What is combining them both? So he is really doing well about, you know, creating peace and making peace. But I hear he's scared as hell. Well, then he has to go deeper into hell, right? If he doesn't want to face it. Grounding, grounding. Yeah. You know, there are masculines that are very familiar with that space of hell and the underworld. So they are able to manage it. There are other men that are not. They are afraid for of a shadow, you know. But they have to face their fears. Otherwise, you become the lamb and you will be played out by everyone around you. Okay, for the Divine Masculine. One card for the Divine Masculine. One card for the Divine Masculine. One card for the Divine Masculine, please. Oh my gosh, it's taking a long time. It's taking a long time. Take this one. Joy. Good, 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 good. One card for the Divine Feminine. Soul Family. Wow, she knows. Yeah, she knew long before he did, or the other way around, but she knows their soul family. Okay. One card for the Divine Masculine. Okay. Oh my goodness. You don't believe this. One card for the Divine Feminine. Trust. Well, holy moly. If you have a question about your twin flame, well, okay, let's do this. Lost cards. Ha! Lost cards. Good. Two. One more, please. One overall card. One card for the masculine. What they say, if you're coming if you're coming in with manipulation to say what the Divine Feminine wants to hear, you're on the wrong path. That's what I hear, because she sees through everything. You can't fool her. So if you come with your authenticity, she will open space for you. If you come in with to tell her just the story that you want to hear, stay away. Okay, this is what spirit says. Oh my gosh, you're so funny. Grounding. Both of you need grounding. Both of you need to go to the earth. You know, getting, maybe it's you're in the city too much and you need to get out of the city. You need to get out of the hectic energy of working. You need to get out of, you need to go and ground with Mother Nature, you know, under the tree, connect with the trees, you know, and go there. Really, really amazing. I just told a friend something about the trees. New beginning for the divine feminine and the divine masculine. A new adventure awaits. Embrace it and live your dreams passionately. So in what kind of energy you are, what kind of thing you do, everything what you're doing, could be that there is a new job coming, could be that there is a new love coming. In every adventure you take, do it with passion. Embrace it. Okay? And then it's Imrama. Well, I had to change cameras because my battery was dead. So this is Imamra. Where are you being called to journey to? Wow, there's a call that needs to be heard. So it could be that you need to make another journey. Oh, wow, this is Petra. Huh. So it has to do with traveling because I was already in Petra. That was an amazing town. High frequency place. And now they asking you, where are you going to journey to? What's your call to be journeyed to? What's your call that they call you to go to? You know, and feel that call and go there. Because there's something that you need to, that they want to show you. There's something that they want you to know. So, and it's probably for both of you. Both of you get signals that you need to go to a place, you know, to journey to. Maybe it's, oh wow, I hear, maybe the masculine needs to journey to the divine feminine, and the divine feminine needs to journey to the divine masculine, if that's the call. And it could be that if you are a light worker and a grid worker, that you get called to go to a place that you need to upgrade or that you need to work with. You know, it's the spiritual world is nothing about not doing the work. It's not about being being in a spiritual place and not doing the work, right? So that, yeah, that's not, and it's not for your own gain. A lot of people misunderstand the spiritual work. Spiritual work is what you give to the earth, what your prayers are, and it's not what you gain out of it. So, you know, you can offer your services, and you can make a living out of that. But your real spiritual work is doing the work on the land, is doing the work with Mother Nature. Okay. So, you can meditate your whole life, but it doesn't mean that it will make a change if you don't doing the real work. Yeah, then you're not, yeah, okay. Then you're not connecting really with what needs to be connected with, you know. It's not all about being up in space, but also doing the work on the earth and on the ground. So that's why they say, you know, ground that light from the universe into the earth. Okay. For the divine masculine, a lot of joy. Joy, 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 happiness, golden age, golden abundance, creation, you know. There's also, if it comes from the heart space, and well, I don't want to even go to karma, because the men that have a difficult time at the moment, you know, they're going to some payoff of karma, and you know, they will come out of it, but it will take another 3 to 5 years before they come, before they're clean out their karmic life, you know. Yeah, it's wow. But go to the joy, go to the joy. I see the in the fifth dimensional realm, I see masculines having a lot of joy, having a lot of fun, being creative, happiness, all of that, because they doing the work, they're doing the work. And then, oh my gosh, you are twin flames. Your passion ignites. You know it's the twin flame journey where you're in. You know what you're doing. You know what your mission is in this twin flame journey. In this twin flame journey, it is to connect and create with each other. So it could be that you are starting to work together, starting to do things together, starting to, yeah, that's what twin flame. I had two friends over this weekend or this week, and they are true twin flames, and they're working together, and they're so loving, and it's so easy, so easy to be with. So yeah. That's the twin flame journey. That's the twin flames, the real twin flames. Wow. The masculine knows it. The masculine, it's on the masculine side. The masculine knows that they are twin flames. Oh my gosh. Well, they're in for a heck of a ride. Starseed, where's this coming from? Okay, thank you. It's really funny. Starseeds. They're star seeds. They start to know now that they are star seeds and that they are here for this time, that they are born to protect this time, to be in this time, and to change this to change this new dimensional realm, you know, to change everything what's going on in the world. He knows it. And what lights you up? What lights you up in knowing this? What is it what really lights you up in being a starseed? Because if you know what lights you up in being a starseed, you know, you are out there, you know, traveling, astral traveling, journeying, you know, going into Mother Earth, you know, doing all the fun things that you need to do, to travel, to hang out, to be creative, you know, do all the things that you want to do. And it really lights you up. Divine Feminine, it's your soul family. You know it's your soul family. And there's nothing more than to connect with soul family. And that's not a choice you make with your mind. It's not a random person you enter on the street. It's not a random person that you met. You know, this is not a rebound, you know. It's soul family is in the heart space. And they're all connected in the heart space. You know, that's a soul family. It's not a normal family. No, the whole family is a soul family. So they're all connected with their souls. One to the other, you know. And it's strong, it's powerful. It's the people you feel safe with. It's the people you can talk easily about anything. Anything. You know, and that's your soul family. And you will meet more soul family coming your way. More soul family is coming your way. You know, trust for the divine feminine. Transformation occurs through acceptance. Once you accept the current situation, it will automatically transform. Wow. That is amazing. That's amazing. Because that's exactly what I went through. And it's just accepting that the things are that they are. And even if you are in a different realm, or you know, even if you have countries between you, even if you have oceans between you, even if you have if you're on the other side of the world, you know, if you accept it, you know, you can change every situation. Nothing wrong about that. So, and it will automatically transform. It's radical radical acceptation is what you bring to the table. And that's for a lot of feminine still not acceptable, right? So a lot of feminine still can't accept things how they are. And that's still their journey, because that's still the lost cloak, or that's still the cloak they need to release. So guys, this was it for this week. It was a long one again. So I hope you're all well doing well. And I see you next time. If you want to have a reading, please book now. Because when my bookings are going through the 26th of August now, so almost till into September, I still have slots left for next week. So if you want to have next week, I have two slots left. So you can fill that in. After that time, I will be available around the end of August. So let me know if you're interested. Because also the Divine Masculine readings are going through. And the normal readings I do are still moving forward. So yeah, let me know if you want to have one of those slots. And yes, if it's still a long reading again, it's the channelings don't stop. So if you want to take your time and want to read this in three times, or in longer or shorter slots, or you want to review it, you know, go and be my guest. And I see you, and I love you all, and lots of blessings. Bye bye.